Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com, here at Archbishop Spalding, where the Cavalier boys lacrosse team of Coach Brian Phipps in the win column for the eighth time in 10 starts this year. Maybe the biggest one, significance-wise, a 14-8 victory over Calvert Hall. Archbishop Spalding has been in the A conference since, I think, 2005, and today, for the first time, they knock off the Hall as Josh Tang had 5 goals, and Michael Weisire, did I pronounce that? I've been pronouncing
Weisire.
Weisire also had 5 goals as coach. The subject of today was your offense, which really struggled against Loyola on Friday, really came to life today. Kind of talk about that.
Yeah, I mean, credit to our guys and Coach Ford, who kind of challenged our guys to come back and get back to playing Spalding lacrosse and sharing the ball and kind of swinging around. And, you know, we don't have one particular best player. It's a lot of great players on offense that share the ball and get the job done and kind of execute it well today.
Right. What key turning point, and there's several turning points, but the biggest one, of course, is at the X. Talk about your faceoff guys.
Yeah, we're very fortunate to have two solid faceoff guys in Blake Malanfi and Trey Fleece. And not only they, you know, great face-off technicians, but they battle for the ball and they're competitors out there, and they can kind of, they'll win the first draw, they can fight for it, scrap for it, and get the ball, and that obviously helped us in that end of the start of the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and just talk about the maturity this team showed. I mean, you guys up 5-2, you guys had a couple of 4-goal leads. Calvert Hall gets it to 2. Momentum is actually kind of swinging towards them. I mean, you guys always seem to always come up with an answer. Kind of talk about that and that maturity to respond.
Yeah, we definitely have a veteran group. You know, the best part about it is the chemistry that they enjoy being around each other. So credit to our guys that kind of battle tested. And this is obviously one of the first years that we're going in believing we can win every game that we play. It's something that, you know, we've been striving for and have that confidence going in to believe in ourselves. And we're going to play our best when we believe in ourselves and have that confidence. And hopefully we keep that going.
Yeah, and elaborate on that a little bit more, because I think after Friday's game, you know, some people who just don't believe in Spalding kind of says, "Oh, same old Spalding, you know, nice team, you know, but that's about it." But today, you guys, this was a statement win for this program.
Yeah, I mean, I trust our guys. I think this is a great group of guys in the locker room and guys that come out and compete every day, and they just want that next opportunity. You know, we kind of say, you know, nothing's guaranteed, so the most important play is that next one. And kind of getting knocked down a little bit on Friday, we got back on Sunday practice, Monday practice, and then ready to go Tuesday. So kind of credit to our guys that we bounced back after a loss, and hopefully we can keep this thing going.
Yeah, and real quick, you guys wearing pink for breast cancer awareness. Your backup goalie, you know, got in there, was able to close out the win. I know his family is going through a fight right now. I mean, just talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, we talk about this as, you know, Spalding, and the best part about sports is the family nature that we have and the culture, and the guys really bond with each other. And our three goalies, you know, they get along great. Jake Oliver, Connor McMahon, and Ryan D'Angelo, kind of, you know, three very solid goalies. And, you know, it's really cool to see them kind of take each other under their wing and be that goalie group back there and really take Connor under and be part of the family and help out best we can. So it's something cool to see, and it's really, really touching to see that everybody care and come around Connor and his family.
Right, right. Great win. You know, beating the 3-time defending champs is always a huge win, but no rest in the MIAA conference. And literally, you guys, less than 48 hours going down 97 to take on your neighborhood rival, St. Mary's, and what will be maybe the biggest lacrosse game between you guys and maybe in years, considering what's at stake as far as seeding for the tournament.
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, it's a great challenge to play them, and, you know, definitely a good rivalry that we enjoy. You know, playing in Anne Arundel County, and it's great to see the success that the Anne Arundel County teams are having with the Baltimore Big Boys, as they say. So it's exciting to see. We got our work cut out for us, and hopefully, you know, Thursday is a great showing and people tune in.
All right. Well, Brian Phipps, coach of the now 8-2 Archbishop Spalding boys lacrosse team. They are now 6-2 in the MIAA conference after a big 14-8 victory over Calvert Hall. Thursday, 4:00 down in Annapolis, it will be Spalding and St. Mary's as these two teams are fighting for a high seed in the MIAA conference playoffs, which is only a couple of weeks away. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tony.